Most of you have given this examination. Most of you have given this UGC NET June 2019 examination. And this is just a subject-wise analysis of this June 2019 about what are the subjects which are very important and what are the subjects which are less important. Less important means if they are asking only one or two questions from a subject, if the subject is very lengthy and very large, so obviously you can leave that portion. So in UGC NET examination, you see that we have a total of, 23 subjects are there. So if you count the subjects, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. So roughly you can say 23 subjects are there which we can categorize. You can even count these subjects individually. For example, you have mobile computing, you have data communication, you have computer networks. So you can also count these subjects. But again, roughly there are 23 big or important subjects are there. Out of all these subjects, there are a few subjects that you can leave in your preparation. So I'm not going to focus on those subjects initially, but again, if we have time in the end, then we will cover those subjects. So this is the analysis of June 2019. You see, from digital logic subject, they have asked around 3 questions. Then from programming languages like C, C++, or other object-oriented programming, they have asked 5 questions. From data structures and algorithms, they have asked a total of 6 questions. From theory of computation, they have asked 7 questions. From compiler design, they have asked 4 questions. Operating system, 7 questions. Computer architecture and organization, 7 questions. And DBMS, 8 questions. Computer networks, 11 questions. From discrete mathematics, they have asked a total of 11 questions. Data mining, total of 1 question only. You got only 1 question from data mining. Software engineering, 8 questions. Unix, 1. Microprocessor, they have not asked any question from microprocessor in this June 2019. Then from linear programming problem, LPP, they have asked only 1 question. From computer graphics, 4 questions were there. Artificial intelligence, 12 questions were there. HTML, XML, 2 questions are there. Advanced DBMS, which include NoSQL as well as big data, they have asked only 1 question. And from Internet of Things, mobile computing, they have asked only 1 question. So if you see all these subjects, the complete analysis of all these subjects, there are many subjects from where they have only asked 1 question. For example, from data mining, only 1 question was there. Unix, only 1 question was there. Linear programming problem, which is a huge subject, very lengthy subject. And they have asked only 1 question from linear programming. And then you see from data advanced DBMS, which is, includes NoSQL and big data, they have asked only 1 question. And from Internet of Things and mobile computing, they have asked only 1 question. So these are the subjects which are, the weightage of these subjects is very less, because if you see, just to cover linear programming problem, it will take you around 30 to 40 hours, and you're going to spend 30 to 40 hours for doing only 1 question, and even then the guarantee of solving the question correctly is very less, because the problems are very lengthy here in LPP, and because the problems are very lengthy, so they are going to consume lot of time. Problems are going to consume lot of time, and it is kind of a waste of time. So what I suggest is you should focus on the subjects where you got at least 3 or more than 3 questions. For example, digital logic is important, programming is important, algorithms is important, theory of computation and compiler design, you can study both of these subjects together. So total there are 11 questions from this part. Then you have operating system, which is 7 questions. So any subject from where you got 3 or more than 3 questions, you should finish that subject in the beginning. So if you see the weightage of all these subjects, so you understand that one of the maximum weightage or most important subject is your discrete mathematics. The second most important subject is your computer networks, or you can say digital communication. And the third most important subject here is your artificial intelligence. So out of 100 questions, just from these 3 subjects, this is 11 plus 11 is 22. And this subject is 12, which is equal to 34. So you can see out of 100, 34% of the questions are coming from these 3 subjects only. And 34% is a very big number, because you see, just by completing these 3 subjects properly, you can secure those 34%, which is a very big deal in UGC NET. If I do the same kind of analysis for unit wise, if I do the same unit, same kind of analysis for a unit wise, so from the very first unit, which is discrete mathematics plus linear programming, total 12 questions they have asked. And out of all these 12 questions, you can leave this part, which is linear programming. You can leave linear programming and focus more on discrete mathematics, because 11 questions are from this part only. The next is digital logic, computer architecture, and microprocessor. From here, you can leave microprocessor. From here, you can leave linear programming. You can focus on digital logic, computer architecture, and organization. Discrete mathematics, this is important. From this part, you see the problems related to HTML and XML, they are very easy. Just to cover HTML and XML, you can do the complete HTML and XML within one single day, because HTML is very easy portion, very easy portion that you can do. So you can do this HTML and XML within one single day, and you can finish your C, C++, and programming language fundamentals. This is also important part. And computer graphics, again, it is also an important part. Then focus on DBMS, data mining and big data. You got two questions from this part, one or two questions. So I think you can cover it later on. You can leave Unix, focus on operating system. Focus on software engineering, because it is important. From this part, it is also, this is data structures, not digital structure. This is data structures. So this part is also very important. Focus on this part, because you got 11 questions from this part. And from this part, you can leave IoT as well as mobile computing, because they are a wastage of time. And this part is also very important. So roughly you can say, out of 100 marks, if you are going to leave these subjects, which is LPP, microprocessor, Unix, Internet of Things, and mobile computing, if you leave these subjects, still you are covering 90% of the syllabus thoroughly. So it is better to cover at least 90 to 95% of your syllabus thoroughly, instead of wasting time on the subjects which are not important or which are not necessary. So I've done the same kind of analysis for July examination also. So let me rub it first of all. So I've done the same kind of analysis for July examination also. In July, you got digital logic, 7 questions. Programming and algorithms, again, 14 questions. TOC 9, operating system 9, computer architecture and microprocessor. I guess it is only from microprocessor they're asking one question. From compiler design in July, they got only one question. DBMS 9, computer networks again 8, discrete mathematics again 14. So again, you can see this is the most important subject, because the basics of discrete mathematics are going to be used in every subject. Even if you are doing digital logic, even if you are doing data structures, even if you are doing digital communication or any subject, the most important subject is your data structure. And today we will be starting data structure. Sorry, the most important subject is your discrete mathematics, not data structure. So the most important subject is your discrete mathematics, and today we will be starting discrete mathematics in this session. So who all are online? Let me see, let me have a look. Praveen, good evening. We have Davinder, good evening. Vijay, good evening. Gulam, Safdar, good evening. Darpan, and Navjot, and Gitanjali. Okay.